Hello, in this video I will tell you about the dimension style override. So in the previous video we have made a dimension style, and using that dimension style we can add dimensions in our drawing. Now what if we want to make very small change in that dimension style? What if you want to make only few dimension style with that change dimension style? For that, obviously we can create new dimension style, but if you don't want to create new dimension style, you can create a temporary override of that dimension style and you can add dimension with that. To make the point clear, I will go to this annotate tab and I will make sure that this dimension or our dim style is selected. So when you click this drop down, you will see a preview of that dimension style. Now with that dimension style selected, I will make few dimensions. So select linear, then click on this end point and I will click this end point. So here we have our own dimension style with all its properties applied. Now I want to make small changes in this dimension style. For that, I will once again click on this drop down and select manage dimension styles. So here we have our own dim style. In order to change it or in order to add override, simply select this dimension style and select this override button. Now it will open with all properties which are assigned to our dim style. Now we will make some modification here. So I will change the color of dimension lines to bilayer and also extension line to bilayer. Now I'll leave the text color as yellow and click OK. As you can see, a new override style has been added under this dimension style. Now click on close and let's make a new dimension. Now we have this dimension with the change property and it is sticking with the properties of our dimension style override. You can even add more dimension style and it will take the property of override in this way. You can remove the dimension override from the dim style window. So click on this window, select manage dimension style from this window, simply right click this override and select delete. You can also rename this override to make it permanent dimension style. So if you rename it, it will become a new dimension style, but we don't want to do that. We simply want to delete and press OK. The override is no longer present, but still the dimension will have the property with override. Now if you want to remove these properties and if you want to have the property of original dimension style, then simply select the dimension, right click and select this option, remove style overrides, and it will return back to original dimension style. You can repeat the process for this dimension or any other dimension which you may want to change if they are present in your drawing. So this is all about the dimension style override tool in AutoCAD.